Hydro, excellent news!
That is excellent news. I was thinking about using it earlier.
I know, it's pretty good, isn't it? But no, seriously, boy, I have good news! My old friend Blax is coming back to town!
Oh, no!
Blax is a true blue American, Pedro! What are you on about?
I thought he was black. How can he be black and blue? Did he get in a fight?
Well, he's gotten many fights, boy. He's a true patriot. He fought for his country. He helped me defeat the evil Fu Manchu in the war.
Fu Manchus? Like the cereal?
Exactly, boy. That cereal was founded by my communist archenemy to try and bring down American cereal empire.
Oh, no.
But Pedro, because Blax is coming to visit, I want you to go to the cigar store and get us 3 cigars to use.
Okay, I will go to the cigar store and buy 3 cigars.
I didn't catch that, boy, but I'm sure you're gonna go to the right place and get the right thing, like you always do, because you're a good boy, a good, good boy. You didn't do nothing.
Yes.
Alright, now that Pedro's gone, Sherlock, I need you to investigate something important. Of course, your sergeantess. That's why I'm here. What do you need? I need you to find the location of the possessed Gary Gat. He's been giving us some serious trouble, and I need you to track him down. Because I don't want to be prepared for trouble and then have to make it double. Yeah, that would be quite a quandary, wouldn't it? Alright, I'll track him down. You got my word on it. Or my name isn't Sherlock Bones! Thanks, Sherlock. I knew I could always count on you.
10 seconds later, at the cigar store.
Hello, it is me, Pedro. I came here to buy 3 cigars.
Oh, hello there, little Mexican boy. You came here to my store. I'm so grateful. Would you like to buy some cigars from me? That is making me so great, so happy right now. Nobody ever buys a cigar.
Yes, I would like to buy the cigar now.
Would you like the cigar in large or medium large or in the small large sizes?
I don't know what any of those sizes are.
No, like the large, small, it's like a small, but it's large, but it's like, and then if you want this medium large, it's like a large, but it's medium.
But like, can I just have the 3 sitars?
No, you have to pick the size of the sitar, you know, you got, you don't understand the culture.
Okay, I'll buy a medium large, a small large, and a medium large.
I'm sorry, we're all out of those sizes. Come again.
What?
Okay, I got these cigars. You can have these cigars. I was trying to put a trick on you for more money, but I don't think it worked.
Okay, thanks for the cigars.
Wait, don't you want to hear about my culture?
No, not really.
Well, in my culture, we like to rub the cow manure on our heads for the fertilizer. It makes the hair grow nice and big.
That sounds gross.
No, it you put it on the face and you get the nice big beard. It makes the ladies very, very happy. Yes, we rub the cow feces on our faces to grow the beard. It is the spirit of the cow.
Your spirit of the cow is disgraced to my spirit of the buffalo. You are disgraced to the name Indian, and my ancestors are stronger than your ancestors, and I brought a buffalo here with me.
Oh my god, that buffalo is getting me so randy right now. I'm getting so horny over that buffalo. It looked like my third wife.
Oh my god, he's raping the buffalo! My ancestors, the spirit of my ancestors, are being defiled!
Oh my god, I did not know the buffalo makes such the thick milk.
I must defend the honor of my ancestors! Here's my spear! Taste my steel!
Oh my god, oh my god, your ancestors are really good. Oh, I love your ancestors.
Alright, you two dumb shits done arguing so I could get in here and rob this place like a true Canaanite.
Oh my god, it is my god. What has happened to you? They've cut off your arms.
What's this? You got a problem with my robot arms, huh?
Oh my god, I remember you having 4 arms and now you don't even have 2. Oh my god, what have they done to my boy? They massacred my boy.
Who you calling boy, motherfucker? You white supremacist piece of shit?
Oh my god, talk to me like that again, daddy god.
You getting fresh with me, boy?
Oh my god, I'm getting fresh. I'm getting all kinds of things from you. I recognize you as my god because you have this spiral on your head. Your hair, it grows in the shape of a spiral. If I give you cow manure, I can make the most beautiful spiral.
Well, tell me something here, motherfucker. You recognize this fist? Ah! Take that!
Oh my god, I do recognize this fist. This is Oh my god, I've never experienced such pleasure in my life. Do it again, oh god.
That's it, motherfucker! Take this, and this, and recognize this, bitch!
Oh my god, I've been blessed on this day. Oh, thank you so much. Oh my god, I could not have wished for a better wish from my genie.
Suddenly, a genie materialized out of nowhere.
Hey, Neil. How you doing, old buddy? It's your old pal, Genie.
Oh my god, Genie. I would like to use my 3 wishes now. Please, Genie. I need to use my 3 wishes.
Oh, perfect. I'll do that. What are your wishes?
Oh, Genie, he's punched me to a bloody pulp and he's ripped off my arms, Genie. I wish for a new pair of socks.
Oh, your wish is my command. You never had a friend like me.
Oh, my God. Thank you, Genie. My arms are gone, but at least my feet are warm. Bless you, Genie.
Hey, what are your other wishes, Neil?
My second wish is for you to blow me and suck my cock.
How about another wish?
No, that's my wish, Genie. You are my slave, and you have to do my bidding, Genie.
That's one of the new rules. No wishing for the genie to blow you.
No, it is not, Genie. I have it in the rule book. It does not say. It says you do what I tell you. Now, Genie, this is my wish. I tell you. I told you to help a crippled Indian.
You want to keep beating him, please? let's get him unconscious.
Genie, please. Okay, I changed my wish. Would you like to give me another wish, Genie?
Okay, what's your other wish?
I want you to lick my ass.
Can we go back to the blowing?
Genie, you keep dodging my wishes, and I've had it with you. You must be executed right now. I am calling the genie police, for you have been a very naughty genie.
There's no such thing as genie police, you idiot.
No, they are here now. We are the genie police. We heard you were not answering his wishes.
You know what? Just take me to fucking jail.
No, that's not how it works. You have to fulfill his wishes.
Daga kotowaru.
What?
It means but I refuse.
That's not how it works. Now you have to give him 3 more wishes.
All right, that's enough of this bullshit. Hiya! Take that.
Why did you beat up that guy on the street?
I don't know. Looked like a white supremacist to me.
Oh my god, Genie. Oh my god.
Now then, I'm gonna knock this fucking store clerk unconscious, and you, Mexican guy, help me rob this motherfucker.
Well, it's not the thing I would usually do, but okay.
Alright. 1 hour later.
Hello, Sarge. I made a friend today.
That's good, Pedro. What happened?
He beat the crap out of some Indian man and ripped off his arms.
Oh yeah? That's pretty cool.
He beat him up so bad he ended up in a hospital on Guerrero Street.
What a story, Pedro. What did this guy look like?
He's a black man and he's missing both of his arms.
Wait a minute. That sounds like blacks! Did he come here with you? Or did you go your separate ways?
He came here. He's back in black.
That's right, motherfucker. I was here to rob your place because I followed this bitch home. But since it's you, I guess that works out since we were supposed to meet up.
Blacks, you son of a bitch!
Alright, well, listen, you white supremacist old piece of shit. I'm here to teach you some lessons about what we did wrong back in the war.
What do you mean? We were heroes. We took bullets for our countries. You lost your arms!
It don't matter, boy. This country's a racist country that was founded by slaves. We're the real Native Americans. You built your land on our land. This is stolen, melanated land owned by us Canaanites.
What?
Sounds legit.
No, it doesn't, boy. What are you talking about? He sounds fucking retarded.
No, you don't understand. This country was founded on racism. And on top of that, we're...
Yeah. Good thing.
It is not a good thing, you fucking racist white supremacist.
Listen, Sarge. Just because I'm your friend doesn't mean you can say that you're not racist. What are you talking about? I never said that.
God damn it, Sarge. You gotta work with me here. I'm trying to fix you. I'm trying to help you be less racist, despite your inherent whiteness.
What are you on about?
Well, we're the original Jews, too. You see, we're the black Hebrew Israelites. In prison, I learned a lot, man. I realized that blacks is my slave name. My real name is Muhammad Abul Gagingi Magush Makrishna Muhammad Ali, Baba Ganoush.
Rolls off the tongue.
I'm not gonna call you that, boy.
What the fuck, motherfucker? I thought we were supposed to be friends.
I'll call you that. I respect your culture. Ooga booga booga ooga googa.
Fuck you, bitch! You think you're woke? You're not woke. I gotta help the world get woke, don't you understand? I can't sit around waiting for people to get woke when I could speed things up. Come on, let me show you.
Let me show you the error of your American ways. Pedro, I'm worried here, buddy. I think we gotta tag along with him and make sure he's all right. I think he's got the brain worms.
I think you have the brain worms. You're Sarge, not worried.
RDRR, boy. RDRR. The only reason either of us would have brain worms is because you cooked bear meat last Thursday like a fucking retard.
I saw Joe Rogan do it on a podcast. He's on the all bear meat diet.
Well, if Joe Rogan jumped off a cliff, would you? Do you have to do everything Joe Rogan does?
Well, the media says he's a conservative, so yes.
Well, the media's wrong! The media's a bunch of lion dog-faced pony soldiers!
I also worship Russell Brand, as he is also a conservative.
Damn it, boy! I'm gonna teach you a lesson later with the cane, but for now, let's follow Blacks and make sure he doesn't hurt himself.
See, so here's how we do this, motherfuckers. We're gonna rob that store, then we're gonna rob that store, then we're gonna punch that old lady in the face and take her wallet. Because this is how we take reparations. This is how we seek out justice for our people. This is how we prove who the real good people are and put those pieces of shit in their place. Take that, store clerk. Now I got the money. And you, old lady. Hello, yes.
Ow, what the fuck? Ow, give me your wallet, bitch, and I won't kill you. Okay, okay, here, take my wallet. Excellent, now I'm gonna kill you anyway.
Oh, God! What is he doing?
Psh! Oh, God! Me too! Ah!
Take that, you stupid motherfucker! This is what you get for upholding white supremacy! No white supremacists on my premises!
Flex, come on, man! You're going overboard! What are you doing? This isn't like you! Come on, back in the war, we were great buddies! I thought you were going to...
Thought I was what? Dead?
No, I thought you were going to remain a good person! What part of I thought you were going to would lead you to believe I was going to say that? That makes no fucking sense!
I don't know, I just felt compelled to say it.
Well, come on, Blacks, this is ridiculous. You gotta stop. These are innocent people you're going after.
No, they're not. They're white. And white people are never innocent. And the ones that aren't white are just brown faces of white supremacy.
Blacks, what the hell, man?
Look, I don't give a shit about your fucking rules. Look at that. You see that sign?
Yeah, that keep off the grass sign?
Well, I don't play by those rules. I'm going on that motherfucking grass, and there's not a goddamn thing you can do about it.
No, Blacks, you better not. That'll be the final straw, boy. Don't do it.
Who you calling boy, huh? Is that how it is? In that case, I'm going on this fucking grass, bitch! Fucking nigga! I'm going!
No, Blacks! That's it! Citizens arrest time! Good thing I got my trusty handcuffs. Click! Alright, boy. Let's take him into Gaylord at the police station.
10 seconds later, at the police station.
Oh, hello, Tharge, you silly goose.
Here, Gaylord, I brought in another Canaanite for you to throw in a cell.
Oh, good! I haven't had a Canaanite in a while.
Really? Why? They commit the most crime.
Well, that's true, but the thing is, the mayor's passed a new ordinance saying that we gotta arrest people of multicultures. We gotta have people of all colors, part of his All Colors Initiative. So we've had to have some more diversity in the people that we've wrongfully arrest.
Oh, that sucks.
Can I get arrested? I commit the other 50% of the crimes.
No, I'm sorry, you silly goose. We really can't do that because you're a main character.
Oh, I thought you were just gonna give me special privileges because I'm actually Jewish.
You what, you silly goose?
Yeah, I'm Jewish, so that means I can do whatever I want, right?
Yeah, of course.
I thank you for exposing yourself.
Well, I mean, I had my fly down, I was getting a little Oh, you mean with that? Oh, okay.
You'll be one of the first that gets in the chamber with the rest of the degenerates.
Now anyway, Gaylord, enough of this small talk. Here's a real genuine Canaanite.
You ain't taking me alive, motherfucker! I'm getting out of here! I'm getting out of here!
I can't understand anything he's saying.
You're not getting out of here, you son of a bitch! Take my knee of justice! Ah! My neck! Ah, his knee's on my neck! Oh, God! I can't breathe! Mama! Mama!
My God, his last words were oonga boonga ooga booga booga.
It's true.
What does it mean?
I think it meant that he had a sled as a child.
Well, those are good last words.
1 hour later. Well, he's had a consistent hour of my knee on his neck. I think he's learned the lesson.
Hey, he's not breathing.
Oh yeah, people usually breathe, don't they?
Not me. I gave up on that. Nasty habit.
Well, then just for that, you get to go, you silly goose.
Oh, thanks. Oh, God.
I told him he needed to breathe. It's not my fault he fucking died, jackass.
Tell you what. You're under arrest for suicide now. Throw him back in the cell, boys, and throw that dead Canaanite in with him. Oh, look, there's cars outside. I think the media's here. Let me do the talking, boys. Don't worry about this.
Today, I'll be interviewing Gaylord. Now, what do you have to say about what you've done?
What do you mean what I've done? I've just upheld the law. That's all I did. Honest to God.
My assessment of the situation? There is a dead black man in that jail cell, and there is another dead man in that jail cell, and you're covered in blood, so what? I'm gonna say you're probably innocent.
Exactly! Oh shit, the mayor's here too!
Hello! It is me, the mayor!
Wait a second, weren't you at the Harambe trial?
Yes, but if you think that's bad, you should have seen me at the Harambe trial!
Flashback. Now, I'm not a big city lawyer, but this ape is clearly guilty. Look at this. He killed 20 children, we saw him do it, there's video footage, and his DNA was all over the kids' bodies.
No! This ridiculous! Look at him! He innocent victim of political prosecution!
How? He killed 20 children.
Yes! Tasty snacks!
He was dealing out social justice!
And having tasty snacks! Come on, that's ridiculous. He doesn't even have human rights, he's a gorilla.
No! He good human! Good American! Like me!
But you're a gorilla.
No! Me human! Just like Hero Harambe! Harambe was just fighting for the rights of African Americans! They got those rights from Abraham Lincoln himself!
What the fuck are you talking about, boy?
Look, I show you! Me so human, me learn sign language! Look at this! Ow! What the fuck?! And I show you again with another sucker punch, you question me again!
What? Fuck you! What? This is ridiculous!
Oh yeah? Me do to you what me did to Robin Williams! Shh! Ah! My nipples! They hurt! They hurt when you twist them! See? Me rational. Me teach bad boy lesson. Me a good boy like Harambe. Harambe's a good boy. A good boy. He didn't do nothing. We don't need this police brutality all over him. We don't need this arrest all over him. He good man.
And judge, you must release him at once. In light of recent evidence and not wanting to be torn apart by a fucking gorilla, I rule that Harambe be set free.
Back to present day.
Didn't he kill like 20 more people the second he got out?
Yes! Good job me!
Also, weren't you at the King Kong trial and didn't you set King Kong free?
Yes! It was good lesson, much like Harambe!
Didn't he like eat 5 women, destroy 12 helicopters, and then he sat on the Eiffel Tower and it collapsed under his weight?
Yes! But he was fighting racism!
Yeah, that makes sense. Wait a second, when did you become mayor?
Just recently, actually. Me got promotion because me diversity hire.
They have diversity hires for gorillas?
Yeah.
And to be mayor?
Yes! Well, not gorillas, but for transhumans like meself!
All right, you silly gooses. We gotta hurry up and get ready, because I bet you there's gonna be a media shitstorm because of all this going on.
What's... A media shitstorm? Oh my god, I'm ready to receive from the gods.
Who are you? Who in face are you?
I just came here for the shitstorm.
That sounds lovely, but me have to deal with this now. You'd commit much police brutality, you police brutalator!
But listen, you silly goose, Mr. Mayor, sir. I'm gay.
Oh! Well, that's stunning and brave. You couldn't do nothing then. You a good boy. Like me. And Harambe. And Ed Gein. And John Wayne Gacy.
Exactly, you silly goose. Now, how about you scurry along back to City Hall and let me deal with this?
Okay, me do that. You smart boy, but not very smart boy, but that's okay, because you gay.
I'm gay too, what do I get?
You get the chair if you keep bugging me!
Oh my god, is it one of those sexy time chairs with the thing that comes out of the chair?
What?
You know, the penis that comes out the bottom of the chair.
No! Me don't have chair like that! It tire swing, like me having me cage back at zoo!
Oh my god, you don't have a chair that penetrates your sexuality?
No!
Oh my god, what kind of you're primitive.
You call me primitive?! Call me primitive, you motherfucker! Me rip you apart because me rational!
Oh my god, I've never been ripped apart by a gorilla before, I'm so horny right now. Oh my god, that was the best gorilla smashing I've ever had. You really fucked me up. That was pretty good. I liked it. I would come again. Please take a massive shit on top of me, please.
Next, I'll be interviewing Blacks. I just figure it's good to get both sides of a story on this one. See if all their testimonies add up. So, Blacks, what did you think when he... What do you think of the situation? I see. And then he did what? Oh, of course. See everyone? Absolutely speechless.
Meanwhile, our top story tonight. There are riots gathering outside the Americatown police station and all over Americatown, USA. They are rioting for causes of stopping police brutality and making it legal for black people to commit crimes. Oh god, you silly gooses, they're everywhere. Sarge, I'm gonna deputize you. Because you did that citizen's arrest earlier, and you served with me in the war. I know you can handle yourself in a fight. What do you say?
Do I get a kick-ass outfit and a shotgun?
Damn straight you do, sir. What do you say?
Don't threaten me with a good time, boy, I'm in!
Can I have a cool outfit and a shotgun?
No, idiot. Why would I give you to that, you silly goof?
Yeah, no, Pedro, fuck you.
Oh, I see. Do-do-do-do.
Alright, Pedro, you know what? You can have a marginally cool outfit and a squirt gun. How's that?
I know the audience can't tell right now, but I'm doing the Snoopy dance.
Into battle we go! Lord, there's too many! We can't hold them off forever!
It's okay, you silly goof. I know a plan.
There's only one man who can handle a leftist mob this size. Oh my god, it's Kyle fucking Rittenhouse!
That's right, and I'm here to kick ass and chew bubblegum, but I'm all out of gum.
I'm all out of ass.
Well, that's good, because I wasn't asking.
I lost it. I was in a terrible accident.
Well, I'm not really sure how to deal with this sort of psychosis, but I do know how to deal with this fucking mob outside. Watch my back, boys. Let's take them out together.
Where is that donkey?
Meanwhile... All right. For our top story, I now have with me, live from the riot, one of the rioters themselves, Seth Rogen.
How's it going? My name's Seth. But I turned myself into a sausage! Funniest shit I've ever seen. Sausage Seth! Wubba-lubba-grub-hub!
Yes, yes, I see. And, what are you doing here? What are your thoughts on this whole riot?
Excuse me.
And what are you going to do to help this riot?
Well, this isn't really a riot. It's more of a peaceful protest, right?
That guy just threw a fucking Molotov into a building.
Yeah, it's fiery, but it's mostly peaceful.
Oh, God! Help! The fire! It burns! My son is dead! Help me! Jesus Christ! Oh, God!
You think these people have never heard of a peaceful protest before? Getting robbed is just part of life in Americatown, USA. Like, look at me. I've been a socialist all my life. You don't even have to think about it, dude. I've been following what Daddy Government has told me my whole life. Sticking with my party loyalty and my blind faith. I'm a mindless lemming. Like any good person would be. I'm sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to do that. That's so rude of me. I'm so sorry.
Why do you keep laughing so much if you're so sorry?
Look, no, I can't help it. I have that Joker disease. I'm actually crying all the time on the inside. I'm a very miserable person. But I did bring something to help the protest. I did bring these woke California bikini babes to use their sexuality as a weapon. Go get them, girls! Oh god, their sexuality is no match for real weapons! Oh Jesus, they're all dead! Oh shit! Actually, this is kinda hot. This is what I'm into. Me and James Franco used to get into some kinky shit like this back in the day before I cut ties with him.
Did you say cut ties? Speaking of cut ties, how you doing? It's me, the Cucumber Quadsman, your biggest fan. Remember me, Seth?
Oh god, not this guy. Hello, Cucumber Clansman. What are you doing here?
I came here to try to get you to notice me and be my friend and do some hoodwatch stuff with me and hang out, and then we go on a date and we kiss and we make babies.
What?
But here's the thing. I don't have enough dedicated WAM for the server because I'm a cucumber, and cucumbers don't have the dedicated WAM. That's just a fact. Look it up in the Cucumber Bible, written back in 1962. For the server. It's for the server.
I don't even know what you're saying anymore.
I'm gonna get the hell away from you, though. You're freaking me out.
Oh my god, it's Sausage Seth Rogen. I'm big fan of the Seth Rogen. I've seen the funny weird movies and they make me laugh my ass off.
Okay, well, good for you.
It is a great tradition of my ancestors that I must uphold, where we shove the big sausage up our stinky asses.
No, you're not gonna do that.
Oh my god, I don't see how you don't have any authority to say no. Look at you and look at me. I'm big, you're little, I'm smart, you're dumb, you're going up my hizzle.
No, I'm getting the fuck out of here. Because I don't want to deal with the consequences of my actions with that riot here. And I want to get away from you and that filthy cucumber.
There is no escape from the stinky cheeseman.
Listen, Seth, you can't get away from me. I'm your fan, and you're my friend, whether you like it or not.
You think you have rights in this country, but you are just a sausage, too. And I'm going to shove you right up my butt.
I don't believe in rights. Except for the white right for a woman to kill her child. That's the only right that's sacred.
I'm about to be amongst my ancestors and go to the highest heaven. Hallelujah.
No, look, what's that?
Now I have disposed of the Seth Rogen and we will never ever hear from him again as he is forever trapped in my bowels.
Oh, God, help me out here. I'm stuck in his anus. Wubba lubba grub hub.
There's nothing funny about where you're going, my friend.
I'm not laughing. I'm crying.
Keep doing that. It feels very good. It is making me really randy.
Meanwhile... Well, Gaylord, it looks like we dealt with him. Yeah, we sure did, Sarge. That was pretty good. You silly goof. Tell you what, Sarge, I'm going to keep you as an honorary deputy, because I feel like that could come in handy in later episodes.
I agree, Gaylord. I will stay your deputy.
I have a deputy!
Here I am. Yep.
How are you, my deputy?
I've ringworm.
Based.
Yeah, Ebola.
Indeed. I have gingivitis.
80% of the population has worms.
That is true, my deputy. I looked it up. Seriously, audience at home, 80% of people have intestinal worms. That's not even a Sergeant French joke. It's true.
I like that we're informing people on all these parasites in this episode.
Right? Including Seth Rogen.
All right, Gaylord. Well, I'm going to head on home and go to sleep. I hope you have a good day, and I'll see you later, my good friend, my good buddy, and my good pal.
Of course, you silly goose. You're always welcome here at my police station. You're my good bud friend and pal, too. 1 hour later...
Oh, my God. I feel him inside me. Oh, my God.
Another hour later...
Sarge, I found him. I found the location of possessed Gary Cat. Time for you to go deal with him. Right. Right, boy. Thank you. All right, time to go fight him. Transform!
Alright, you think you're a match for me, Sarge? No chance! Me, you dirty bastard!
That's my name, don't wear it out.
Well, you don't understand. I was protecting you from
Well, hopefully that wasn't important, whatever she was saying.
No, it wasn't anything important.
All right, boy, fair enough.
Now that Gary Gadd has been killed with Pedro's sister inside of his body, that means that I have no partner in crime. So my only other chance to defeat this hidden monster that's going to destroy us is to hold a world tournament. I'll get you, Pedro and Sarge, and your little dog, too!